Hi, this is ronMctube. We're playing the Hunter on PC, and today we're playing as a brand new player because we're doing a tutorial for all the new players and all the free players, so you can understand what you get, what you need, and how to hunt the new species which are available to you. We're taking a look now at the weapons you get for free and what you can use. You get the 243 ammo and the scope. You also get a 12GA single shot shotgun. I've got birdshot in. There's no scope for this, but you don't need a scope. You get a bleat caller, a camera for taking pictures, and binoculars. You also get the 4.54 Elbison pistol, but we're not going to be using that. If you can't carry any more ammo or equip an item, you can drag an item off and put in what's necessary to be used. So you might have two stacks of ammo, take one out with being a free player and limited room in your bag. Right, we're on Logger's Point, starting at Border Lodge. It's 11 a.m. and all we're going to do is walk straight up the path for a start, because we're going after cottontail rabbits. Now, the species you can hunt as a free player are whitetail, cottontail rabbits, pheasants, and European rabbits. You find European rabbits on Valdebez, which you can go on as a free player, and Bushrangers Run. But first, we're going to go after the cottontails, and I've just marked on the path where we're going to go. Just straight up the path, you don't need to deviate. Just for a start, it's best to do simple. Once you've got a few under your belt, you know a rough location where they are. They're not too hard to find. Just showing on the map now what I'm going to do and where they are in the areas. Where I'm marked on the map first is where the cottontails are. Then we are going to head right down towards the tower where you get pheasants, and also whitetail in those areas where I've circled now. You can get them left or right, but I'm just staying right because most of the species we're after are all in that area on the right. It's a large meadow all the way down to the bottom tower. Okay, we've covered the basics of how we're going to start off. So load your gun. We reloaded the 243. Make sure to reload your shotgun. So we've got a single shot in there, a bird shot, and off we go. One thing I'll mention while you're new, and I'm doing this to highlight in the video, it's up to you how you want to hunt them, but when you start in the game, if you go to scene complexity in the graphics options, it's on the right hand side, just before you start, turn scene complexity to low. This will help you spot smaller animals really good. They'll stand out because a lot of the vegetation is rendered quite low. So as you can see on the trees, they're not fully bushy and the grass is very thin. So just while you're learning the locations of where the animals are, I think that's a good idea, because like I say, you'll find the rabbits easier, you'll spot the pheasants easier. We just had a female mule deer call there. You can't hunt those on a free license. So you used to be able to hunt them, but that's just swapped now, and in its place is whitetails. So we're going to continue up the path. Our first objective is to find a cottontail rabbit. We're just coming up to an area now where you can find rabbits here, literally out the gate. See these trees just in front of me on my left? In those logged areas, there's often quite a few rabbits in there. But to keep it simple, I'm just going to walk up the path. So you literally can't get this wrong, because where I'm going to, there is always rabbits. I don't think I've ever been here and there hasn't been rabbits. So just for almost 100% chance of getting one, that's why I'm going here. But always, you can check in there on the left. You often get one or two in there. I've got my PDA out, and you get your PDA out by pressing tab. If an animal calls, you'll see the notification on it. You can click to see what the notification is, what animal it is, and when you click on it, it will say what species it is and so on. If you don't want to follow that track or you want to ignore it, you just right click, left click to confirm, right to ignore it. Right, we're looking around on the meadow now. You should get used to doing this every so often. Just have a look in front of you so you don't spook the animal. So we're still on the path. I've had a quick look round. Can't see any cottontails. They are all on these fields all around where I am now. So I'll move on a bit. I'm hoping we see some very shortly. If you struggle for any other information, you can also check the forums. The Hunter Wiki is the best place for all the info, one place. There's also the Steam forums to do with the game, so there's lots of places for the information. And there's also other YouTubers who do tutorials and guides. You just have to have a look for those. Right, we've got a track there. You can get footprint tracks, their poo, and audible sound clues to where they are, the animals. So any of those, you'll often get a two-prong line. You're best to stay in between that when you're tracking an animal. There's often three tracks, and then sometimes you get a circle. It can be broken or solid. The smaller the circle is, the closer that animal is to you. If it's broken, it means the animal, when you click on the track, has run off, he's fleeing. So what I often do is, when I get two to three tracks, then I'll slow down a bit and just have a look around to make sure I'm not going to spook it or if I can see it yet. So I'm just looking around on the meadows here because we're about where I wanted to start hunting the cottontails, and you often see them in this area. So I'm just seeing if anything stands out or if it's easy to spot one. I know they'll be here somewhere because they are always here. Now here's a track, and it's our first cottontail track. Right, so we know we're in the location now. We've just got a clue. So we'll check there's some more tracks around here. It might be others, it might be the same one. So we're going to keep checking them. And then we'll just have another visual, a bit slower, and look around. Because obviously, the cottontail is in this area. Now, cottontails often stick to a certain area. They may get spooked, but they often come back to where he was originally. So what you want to do is, if you find a track, stop. Just have a look around, 360, in the area where you are. And as long as you haven't sprinted like and trod on them literally, they will be like squatted down, just either pruning themselves or whatever, and you will see them. So we'll follow the tracks and continue. We're still on the path, just up from the lodge. Hopefully we'll see one soon. I think that's one over there. Without the binoculars, you can see the rabbit, but it's just in a bush. So I'm going to walk over to it with the shotgun, the single shot. It's quite powerful, this is. Now there's two approaches. You can try and shoot it from a distance, but if you've got a shotgun on, you can just literally run up to them. As long as you know where they are and ready in case they do run, and then it's just blast them. One shot should kill them. So there we go. First cottontail down. Now that wasn't too hard, was it? It was just straight up the path from the lodge. So let's collect him. And there's our first achievement. You get achievements when you hit certain targets. You get them for guns, and you get them for animals once you reach a certain one. So every first kill of each new animal you get an achievement and towards your hunter skill points and hunter score. Right, that's the first of the species that are free. We've got that, so that didn't take very long at all. Now we're going to move on, and we're going to go straight forward from where we're facing onto a very large meadow. And we're after pheasants now. I will put the coordinates, I should say, which, if you see at the bottom of my screen, it shows you your coordinates of where you are. You can match that, and then you know exactly where to go. So let's carry on. Our objective now is to get the next free animal, which is the pheasant. Pheasants are quite easy to hunt. You often find them in groups of females and males. The cockbird is brightly coloured, a long tail. The female is quite bland, sandy coloured, smaller bird. Ideally, you want to flush the pheasants, which you press F. It makes like a whistle sound. This scares the pheasant and then they fly up. You shoot them in the air to get earshot. You can shoot them on the ground, but that doesn't count towards leaderboards and so on. So ideally, you want to shoot them in the air. Now, this takes a little bit of practice, so you might not hit them straight off. So don't worry about that, because often they're quite easy to find here. And as I said, they're in groups, so they can be like five or six together. You might miss one, but you might get the next one. The more you shoot them and get used to the speed of takeoff and how they fly, you will start to get better with the single shot shotgun. Also, just recently, they've just added rare pheasants, so you can now get albino pheasants, which are pure white. I haven't got one myself yet, but if you spot them, that is a great trophy. So no pheasants yet. You can find them in this kind of area, but you'll know when we find some, because they're often in groups. You can find the odd one in itself, but mostly they're in a group of like five or six. Mule deer. Remember, we can't hunt them for free. We'll get the shotgun ready just in case we see a pheasant. We're in the right areas. It shouldn't take you many minutes in this location. I'd say within 5 to 10 minutes in this area, you will spot a pheasant. You can get pheasants in other locations. Hirschfelden is very good on the cornfields. You do find a lot there, but I'm just on Logger's Point because I'm trying to get most of the species in one place. So it's a simple guide where you can just hunt here and get most of the species quite easily. So what you want to do is keep clicking on tracks and just keeping an eye out until you find either a pheasant track, which will be like a footprint, or you actually just see them bunkered down in the grass. The pheasant's scoring range is up to 30. That's based on the weight and the length of the tail. So a decent pheasant is, I'd say, is 25 to 26. A big one is over 27. More mule deer calling. We're going to ignore that. Like I say, if you want to ignore a track, right click, and you can still keep on course of if it's a species you're after. So hopefully over here we should see some. This is just like a big flat meadow where I am now, over this ridge. It's basically just like bumpy hills and quite flat all the way down to the tower. Where you find towers in the game, there's always animals there. That's why the towers are there. So if you're in that location, just have a pop in them and have a look round. You might spot something. You don't need to sit in them all day. Just have a quick 2 minutes around, 360. If you can't see anything, generally there isn't anything in the render range. So quick look and then move on. Right, there's our first pheasant. As I was saying, bunkered down. It's a female. Make sure your shotgun's loaded and you've got a shot ready. Last thing you want to do is go and fire and you ain't got a bullet in and you have to reload and it's flew off. So here we go. The pheasants, you can go quite close to them, but just remember, F to flush, shoot just off the ground, and then that's it, go collect them. Often when you shoot one, if there's some more around it, it might spook them and then they might fly off. So sometimes you can get three or four if you're accurate. But here's our first pheasant. It's a female. We'll collect that. Take a little trophy shot with a camera. In the free to play mode, you can only do it like this, but if you remember, you can actually pick them up and pose with the animals. One thing we'll go on to is ethical guns. When hunting any animal in any of the reserves, you need to use ethical weapons. So, like now, if I was using the 243 to shoot that pheasant, which a new player might do if they don't understand, you will get a message from Doc saying you're not allowed to do that. So make sure you're using ethical weapons whenever you're hunting a certain species. If you go onto the store page, that tells you all the guns and what you can hunt with them and what is ethical. Because if you don't use an ethical weapon, it doesn't count the animal. So basically you're hunting for nothing if you're going to shoot the wrong weapons. Also, certain bullets are ethical for certain species as well, with certain guns. So just have a check on either the Wikipedia if you're not sure, or you can use the store and check the guns on there. It's not hard to learn, but it works out. Right, another pheasant over here. Don't be worried if you miss a pheasant, because the way they take off, sometimes you think they're going to fly straight up and it might fly a bit to the side or whatever, and it's a single shot shotgun, so if you miss, you got to reload it and then shoot again. So don't worry if you miss, it's just natural and you'll get better as you shoot it more. So there's a male over there on the right, there's a female bunkered down on my left. I'm going to try and shoot the male this time. We just shot off a female. That's one down. It's a male. It's a female. And we've got that one. Nice and easy. There was another one, I think. So, but we'll just collect those two. So as you can see, short period in. Cottontail done. Pheasant's done. Female. Let's take a look at the cock male bird. Here's the male bird. As you can see, it's got a lot longer tail, a reddish body and a red patch on its head. So you can't really mistake them for the females. That one was 26, so quite a nice pheasant. Take a little trophy shot. And then we're going to move on. We might see some more pheasants along the way, but now we're going to go after whitetail. Now whitetail can be found on Logger's Point. It can be found on Red Feather. You've also got the southern area of White Hart, which is a small island. That is very good, very high population there. So we're just mainly hunting on Logger's Point just because we're all in one place and it's easy to show you there, but there is other locations. You might like one of those better, That's up to you. What we're going to do is carry on. We're just going down to the tower now. Often you'll hear the whitetails call. If you keep looking in the distance, you can normally spot deers as well. So because it's quite flat or there's not much vegetation on these meadows, you can often see the animals before they actually spook. So I'm moving quite quickly down here. You can crouch walk and take it more slower paced. It is really up to you. Let's see if we can get this pheasant. As I just pointed out before, you're not going to hit everyone. Sometimes you'll smash everyone, sometimes you'll miss a few. Don't worry about it, like I say. You'd be a robot if you didn't miss, so. I've been playing this for years, and I still miss, like you've just seen, so. Collect that one, it's another male. Carry on with our hunt. Moving towards the tower. It is quite a nice and easy place to hunt on Logger's Point. Many animals, and because it's so open, it makes it quite fun. Some of the other reserves are more dense, heavily wooded. So this is a good training area to hunt for getting into the game. So what we're going to do is, we're going to try and either see one visually, a whitetail, or hopefully we hear it grunt. Then we use a bleat caller, call it, and bring it to us. Unless we spot it and it's quite close. You get male and females. The males will have racks. They score from average, I'd say, is about 100. The really large trophy ones are like 180 plus. If you wanted to win a competition, it'd be like 185 to 200 for a normal whitetail. There's also non-typical whitetails, which have weird looking racks, and they can score like crazy numbers, like probably double what a normal trophy typical one can score. We've just leveled up there on our tracking. There's various levels. As you level either your weapons up by shooting animals, they get steadier as you level up the item. Or if you level up your tracking, you get better at tracking. And you can see things clearer, like the domes, and you just get better at it as you progress. Right, we're getting in the area now where you might find a whitetail. This area, this is where I'd start looking for them. Have a quick look round. I thought that might be one, but it's a mule deer, which we can't hunt. There's the tower. So often there is animals in this area. So we're just checking the tracks and just seeing if there's anything pointing out for a whitetail being in this area. So nothing yet. There's our path we've took up to yet to get the species we're after. Quite simple, nothing complicated about it. I've got a call there, and it's a whitetail male. That's a male because it grunted. So I'm going to give it a call. There's a bit of a mound there in front of us, and it'll be quite awkward to see it coming. So what we're going to do is, and you should always do this, try and work out where the animal, if you're trying to lure it to you, is coming from. You ideally want the vantage point so you can see it clearly. You don't want to be sitting at the bottom of a hill and it's coming over a hill because you can't see whereabouts it is, and it might spook before you even see it. So we're going to get to a higher point where we can clearly see it. And we're going to keep calling it until it gets in view, and then hopefully shoot it. So I'll just give it another call, and I'm going to sit on top of here and then wait for the whitetail to come in. So ideally, if we get this whitetail, then we're going to move on to shooting the European rabbit. Now you can get those on Valdebez, and you can also get them on Bushranger's Run. But we're going to pick Valdebez after we've got this whitetail. Well, hopefully got it. So we've got the 2-4-3. Just going to have a quick look around. Not here yet, so we're going to keep calling. You can either go to the animals or let them come to you. That's really up to you. If it's a bit tricky terrain or you can't see clearly, it's better to lure them to you really in a place like where you can see from, so you have the advantage. If they're in an awkward spot, then you going to them gives them sort of the advantage over you. So I'm listening for the call, because sometimes it might take a different path from coming straight towards you. It might sort of like move around the terrain. So what you want to do is keep calling every say 30 seconds with a deer caller, and then hopefully you'll get its call and you can locate it before you can see it. While you're waiting for an animal to come in, you can try and work out, play out in your mind how you're gonna shoot it, where you're sitting, if you're gonna crouch, prone. Just work that out while it's coming in, so then when you get the animal in sight, you know what to do and you don't panic. Sometimes when you're new, you might get a bit flustered and just rush the shot. Now onto shot placement. With a deer, you want to hit vitals so it kills it as quickly as possible. So what you want to do is, if they come in front onto you, you want to shoot it about a centimetre up, right in between the front legs and its middle chest. That'll often get heart or lung shots. If it's coming from the side, you want to shoot just after the front leg, near the armpit crease where the rib cage is. That will often give you lungs or a heart shot. If you hit the animal in the body, it's often going to keep running. They can go into a nervous state. If an animal's in a nervous spook state, it stays that way. Probably won't respond to your calls or anything like that for about 12 minutes. So it really does pay to just be steady, like the time now. Work out what you're going to do and try and get your shot. Don't rush it, because like I say, it can take you a long time of tracking that animal back down if you do a bad shot. So the whitetail's just come in view now. Looks a nice male. About 110 to 130-ish. That's the average male in this. I'm going to let him come a bit closer first. The average whitetail males, we won't be too spooky. As the animals get bigger, the trophy ones, they are a bit more skittish. The smaller ones will tend to come in before the bigger ones. The bigger ones might mess you about a bit and they will spook easier. One night it's 200 whitetails like straight away, and any messing about, they're gone. So it's a neat factor, but you just have to remember that. I thought it was another one there, but it's a mule deer. So we're going to take the shot on the white. Nice clean shot. And that's objective complete on Logger's Point. So we shot cottontail rabbits, pheasants, and now the whitetail male. So all in a straightforward, easy follow route. I will put links to material which will help you if you've not understood certain things. So link to the Wiki, some other YouTube channels which have got various videos on different animals, and the link to the official forums, so it all helps. So that was a long heart shot. Objective achieved. That's male whitetail. Now we'll move on to the final free animal, which is the European rabbit. is just a quick look at the route. So it's straight up the road and then veer right, check that meadow down to the tower. That's as easy as it needs to be. The area I'm just circling there is a good area for cottontails. I'll clear that. The area I'm looking at now, ideally, is good for pheasants. So just check that area for pheasants. And then the final areas for whitetail. So around the tower and just before it, and also on the left, there's an area there where you can find whitetails regular. So that's three of the main species covered. Nice simple route. We're going to move on to the fourth. Now on to Valdebes. Okay, we're here on Valdebes. We spawned at Chalet de Mont Bleu, if I pronounced it right. We started at 11 a.m. and it's really simple. You can't get any easier than this. All you have to do is follow the path from behind the house and check this circled area. And there's always European rabbits in those areas. Very simple. And that's all that is needed. So we're going to use the 12GA single shot shotgun. Remember to reload it. If you don't want to see one and not shoot it. And off we go. Follow the path. And what we're looking for is either the tracks, which will have the footprints, or you find the droppings of the animals. Or you'll see the burrows. Now the European rabbits, they have like a burrow system. They look like mini volcanoes sticking out the grass. So what I often do is I often look for a track first, and then once I've located the tracks, and you often get a few because they're often in groups, then I know that the burrows are very close. There's a roe deer. We can't hunt those, not on the free, but one's just called deer. Just got a notification up the top left, and it also tells on your PDA that you can't hunt them on free, so you can't really mistake that. So we'll continue on looking for the Euro rabbits. When we find the burrows, what we're going to do is you sit slightly back from them, and we're just waiting for the rabbits. They pop out of them. You'll see the heads, it's quite comical sometimes, and they'll have a look round and think it's safe. They'll run about for a bit. Often, if you're a bit too close, they'll jump out, look, and then back down in a split second. And at first you might think, how am I gonna shoot those? But if you sit back a bit further, often they'll come out, maybe have a little roam around, and that's the time to shoot them. So as you can see, I'm clicking on all the tracks, just trying to find out the rough location of where the rabbits have gone, because basically they'll roam around and then they go to the burrow system, and that's what I'm trying to locate now, the actual burrow system where the rabbits are located. As you can see, I've got a small circle around me on the PDA. That means they're really close, so they're in this area where I'm looking now. I'm just looking for the burrows, which are like light brown volcanoes just sticking out the ground a short distance. There's often five or six, sometimes it can be like only one or two. It just depends. Remember what we talked about with the ethical guns? We're using the 12GA single shotgun. You can use other shotguns, but because it's free, this is the one we're using. You can't use the 243 rifle. That'll be unethical. So they're around here somewhere, because we've got plenty of tracks. from other rabbits, so we know we're here. Now they're just up in front of us. So now we've located the burrows, what we're going to do is try and find an area to view the burrows, because it's like whack-a-mole. You're waiting for the rabbits to pop up at the hole and then shoot them. We'll just take a quick look at them close up so you know what to look for. There you go. And the rabbits will pop out the centre of them, they either go down them or come out. So there's some rocks over here, so I'm going to use them as my advantage to see from them. If that's too close, I might move back a bit further if they're not coming out. Sometimes you'll get some that's already out as well and they'll come back to the burrow, so you have to keep an eye out all the time, just looking for when you see any sign of them. So as you can see, I've got my binoculars, press 6, bring out the binoculars, look around. You can sit with your gun aimed up, or as I'm doing now, it's a preference really. But you're just looking for signs of their heads popping out, or if they come out and roam about. I have got advanced European rabbit guides on my Hunter channel, so, and many other tutorials and other videos to do with the Hunter. So if you want to know about bigger animals and a bit more advanced in any other thing, I have got the videos on there, so you can take a look at those. This is more a basic guide, just so you can get in, shoot one pretty quickly, and just get to grips with how the game works. So we've not seen none yet. This can be quite common, they don't just run straight out as soon as you get there. Sometimes it can be already at the burrows and running about. Sometimes they run back to them, but sometimes you have to wait a little bit. Sometimes just going further back and then they'll come out. So you just have to try a few little things until you see some kind of indication that they're about or at the holes. And you have to keep a careful eye on the actual burrows, because sometimes you might just see the ears sticking out, and if you're not looking properly you might miss that, and then it might pop up, have a look around and go back down again. So I moved a bit closer. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to move a bit further back. Can't see anything popping out yet, so we'll try that and see if one pops out. So it doesn't look like any's popping out just yet. There's competitions you can do as new players as well, and you can get rewards from doing that. And doing some of the missions, you get a free currency called GMS from doing missions. You can buy certain consumables with that. In the competitions, if you place in certain competitions, which are every day, which you can do as free, you can gain EMS, which can go towards buying equipment and other items. You might not look at doing competitions from the start, but you can do the missions straight away. Now I think it's time to move. None's popped out yet. Normally within a few minutes you see some kind of sign of the rabbits popping up. If you want to steady your gun, I don't know if I mentioned this earlier, you hold the space bar. You'll hear your player, he'll hold his breath and it'll stay steadier during that period. Alright, we're going to move over to this rock over here. It's a bit further away and hopefully the rabbits will pop out then. I could edit it and just show in between, but I want to do it real time so you can see it's not really a big deal, and it's quite easy actually to find this species even if you're a new player. So same again, we're going to sit here perched, we're just going to wait for some kind of indication, and here we go. As soon as we moved, the rabbits popped up and we've shot it. Sometimes if you hit them, they might run to the burrow and die in the actual burrow. You can lie on it and click your PDA and still collect them sometimes. But this one's just outside the burrow. So that's mission complete. That's all the free content shown here. A guide how to get them. I think it's relatively easy how it's been shown. Let's take a trophy shot of the Euro Rabbit. If you need any other help, I'm going to put all the other links in the video description to help you out. Hope this has been useful if you're a free player, or a new player I should say. If you need any more info, I can help you out or point you to people who can help you out so you get better at the game or understand it more. So I'm ronMctube, you're playing the Hunter on PC. Hope this video has been useful. Please subscribe to my YouTube channels and thanks for watching.